they really had it down pat. They have Jesus saying, "Render unto Caesar what is Caesar's," which is basically in response to talking about money. Whose benefit would that be? It's so blatantly obvious.
But you will be convinced in more depth if you read the book. This is just not some other book out there. This book is special. The book will prove once and for all that Jesus was an invented character. After this, there is no return to superstition ever again. Let me introduce to you the book.
Talked about in the last video, we know that the Piso family were the creators of the New Testament. This is historically found. This is historically, we can look this up.
There is no evidence where there should be evidence. And okay, one author not writing about Jesus, okay, you will allow that. Every author? There was a book last year, I think it was, came out, I forget the name off the top of my head, it may come to me, but it was something like 295 documented first century writers, and not one of them mentioned Jesus. Now, at that level of non-evidence, you have to say, come on, this is just not so. You know, it's a fable. It's a fable. And now,
this is just not some other book out there. This book is special. The book will prove once and for all that Jesus was an invented character. After this, there's no return to superstition ever again. Let me introduce to you the book.
Talked about in the last video, we know that the Piso family were the creators of the New Testament. This is historically found. This is historically, we can look this up. The New Testament and all the characters in it, Jesus, Joseph, and all the Marys, and all the disciples, and Paul, are all fictional. That's very hard for me to take. I don't know about you. Very hard. You know, when you have a Pope Leo X quoted as saying, how well will we know what a profitable superstition, this fable of Christ has been for us? We were taught that our forefathers in America were pretty much founded off of Christianity. Although we still do know the story of Constantine Noble, 325 AD, and the creation of Christianity, yet we still block that out of our heads and say, this is the religion of the Bible of God.
This is just not some other book out there. This book is special. The book will prove once and for all that Jesus was an invented character. After this, there is no return to superstition ever again. Let me introduce to you the book.
Talked about in the last video, we know that the Piso family were the creators of the New Testament. This is historically found. This is historically, we can look this up.
This is just not some other book out there. This book is special. The book will prove once and for all that Jesus was an invented character. After this, there is no return to superstition ever again. Let me introduce to you the book.
Talked about in the last video, we know that the Piso family were the creators of the New Testament. This is historically found. This is historically, we can look this up.
And what's interesting is that this shows that the character Jesus Christ is fiction. The events in his life are not original historical episodes. They were simply taken from another book. Now, the same thing is true about the entire rest of Jesus' ministry. It is all taken from another book. The storyline of Jesus is fiction. It was based upon a military campaign of a Roman Caesar named Titus Flavius. The reason that people have not recognized that the character Jesus Christ is fiction is simply because they haven't understood the genre that the Gospels were written in. The Gospels are, in fact, a Roman mockery of a kind of literature that the Jews produced in the first century.
This is just not some other book out there. This book is special. The book will prove once and for all that Jesus was an invented character. After this, there is no return to superstition ever again. You will be convinced in more depth if you read the book.